Well, to talk more about the vaccines, we're now joined by Dr. Anita Ramesh Chandra, Senior Medical Oncologist, Apollo Specialty Hospitals, Chennai, someone who's been involved with vaccine trials, and also Dr. Sanjeev Singh, Medical Director, Amrita Hospital, Faridabad, and member of the Drug Safety Council, Government of India. Dr. Singh, and you know, because of this sort of cloud over Covaxin, you know, being a part of the vaccine drive, initially there was some amount of hesitancy, perhaps hopefully that will be overcome now, especially as we're stepping into the second phase, and hopefully we'll get more vaccines to choose from.
Thank you. I think it is important. The vaccine hesitancy for Covaxin basically came up from the fact that the data was not very clear, and it got an emergent use authorization while Covaxin was still in phase 3 trial. Yesterday it was a very landmark information which came up, which was released by ICMR. And it shows a zero conversion at 56 days of 98.3% and at 104 days of 81.3%. So I'm sure this would be published, but the press release from ICMR and Covaxin together, Bharat Biotech together, is very encouraging. And that would reduce the vaccine hesitancy and the apprehensions which everybody had that it was the information or acceptance of Covaxin into the vaccine administration was slightly done before all the data could come in. So I'm sure with yesterday's information, the vaccine hesitancy would change into a vaccine exuberance, and more takers would be there within the country.
And Dr. Singh, if we talk about, you know, other vaccines that are there's several candidates that are there being developed in different stages. A lot of excitement for Russia's Sputnik V vaccine. You also have Novavax. Tell us a bit about the vaccines that are currently being tested in India.
So there are many other vaccines other than the Covishield and Covaxin, which is right now in use. So the Gamaleya Laboratories Sputnik vaccine, there is a Johnson & Johnson vaccine, there is also Sinovac vaccine. All of this is getting tested, and there is another within the Serum Institute, they have a viral vector vaccines which is also available. All of it is within the phase 2 trial, and it would go on to phase 3, and it has been directly monitored by the Drug Safety and Monitoring Board. More data needs to come in, but 1.3 billion people to be vaccinated, a very high target of 6 lakhs vaccinations per day. There needs to be more people, more companies who need to come in to cover this vaccination, because the target is huge. And to reach up this, definitely India has done a fantastic job. But at least to cover this by July, the target which the government of India has of reaching out to close to 300 million.
Well, time now for our viewer question segment, and Dr. Singh will stay on with us to answer those questions for our viewers. Let's just listen into the first one.
Hello, doctor. I am Prakhya Kaushik from Delhi. My question is, how long the vaccine is effective?
All right, she wants to know how long it'll be effective for.
Such a cute girl. Pragya, the vaccine, the data is still not very robust. It is assumed that it would be there for at least 6 to 8 months of time, but more studies needs to come in. Definitely, right now, the zero conversion rates are at the 12-week post-second dose is good enough to protect us. And I think that is very encouraging. And possibly it would be an annual phenomena. But since the data is still, it would be too premature to comment right now. More research and more data needs to come in.
All right, let's listen into the next question.
My question is, can you still transmit COVID after being vaccinated?
All right, this is something we hear a lot, because even after getting vaccinated, you know, you have to follow all the COVID protocols, and you can even be a carrier and spread the disease?
Yeah, that is why earlier it was said that 81% of them are asymptomatic, and that's why we need to have a COVID-appropriate behavior. And the doctor prior to us had also been mentioning about those important precautions which needs to be maintained. So despite vaccination, COVID-appropriate behavior, hand hygiene, maintaining social distancing and masking will still be very, very key element to prevent the spread.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Sanjeev Singh, for joining us on the show today.
Thank you so much.